So you have the reality. You have the power to create all reality. You have the power to create all reality right now. And I'm not just saying that, you really do. And you use it every day. When you wake up in the morning, oh, I feel great. Today, I'm gonna go to work, and then after work, I'm gonna go listen to a few life-changing TED Talks, and then after that, I'm gonna go to sleep early. And you do, sometimes. The power you use every day to change reality is words. Though right now, many of you aren't particular about the words creating your reality. The ones you think, the ones you speak, and the ones you allow your ears to hear. All of those words combined can create the reality of your dreams, the reality of your fears, or something in between. Now, some of you may have tried to use your words to create the reality of your dreams, but it didn't come true. Or other times, you tried to prevent the reality of your fears, and despite you using your words to prevent it, it came true. The similarity of those two is in the way you instructed reality. If you are particular in your words in a way reality understands, the life of your dreams will be created. Last year, my mom and I were driving in Vermont. It's a state in the US. And it was dark in the middle of winter. And we're driving down this road. The trees are bare. There's snow on the ground. And in the distance, there's a car stopped on the middle of the road with their blinkers on. It was stuck. We pulled over. And my mom sticks her head out the window and says, "You don't need help, right?" And the driver looks back at her all confused. "Nope." And we start to drive off. And in the mirror, I see another car pull up, exchange some words, and then pull over to help the other car. My mom tried to create the reality of assistance. She wanted to be a helpful person. She wanted the other driver to be helped. She just used the wrong words. I was fascinated by how someone trying so hard to help was unable to while the next person was. This inspired me to get really clear on my words. I realized the words in my own head were important, the words that came out of my mouth were important, and the words that went in my ears were important. You may have heard of the placebo effect. When a doctor gives you a pill that's filled with sugar and tells you that it'll cure your illness, and it does, but there's no medicine, how does it work? The doctor's words created your reality of healing. The opposite is true as well. It's called the nocebo effect. In a 1981 study, Schweiger and Parducci took a group of college kids and they put them in a room. They informed the kids that they will be putting an electrical current through their heads and it may cause a headache. They proceeded to put the helmet on these kids and then do absolutely nothing. But then 67% of these kids reported having a headache. The reality was, there was no electrical current. There was nothing to create pain. But the words the doctors used created the reality of pain in 2/3 of the kids in the study. This shows the danger of words. It's not just your words that create reality. It's all of the words around you, even now. From the music you listen to the movies you watch, to the people you spend your time with, and to the talks you listen to. All of those words combine to create the reality as you know it. So I think this is a really good time to thank you all for coming. I know offering your ears to my words is showing incredible trust. And for that, I am grateful. And I promise to use only words in which creating the reality in which you will utilize your words to create the reality of your dreams. And I'm offering you this power because I know you who showed up here today will use this power for good and change reality for the better. So words inspire everything. How we feel, what we do, what we believe, how we experience, how we define life. To explain how this works, let's create a new reality of our own together, right here, right now. And then after that, I'll take you through a series of historical examples so you can see this in action. The first step to creating the reality of your dreams is understanding the reality of the moment. Once you understand the reality of the moment, you can focus your efforts on creating the reality you really want. For example, right now, what is reality? You're here, you're sitting down, you're in this beautiful venue put on by none other than Kiba Murray and her team and their hard work. It's 25 degrees Celsius, and depending on whatever you told yourself, that could be hot, that could be warm, or I was informed the other day by Kiba's sister that it's kind of chilly. You're listening to a TED Talk. The room is brown, there's a screen behind me. That's what reality is. The second step is to choose a reality that you want to create. We are all here in this room together. We are all giving 20 minutes of our time, which is our most precious resource. The current reality is that there's a TED Talk is happening. If I was you, sitting in your chair like I was for the previous two speakers, I would have come in hoping that this was a good use of my time. And what that looks like is hearing a life-changing TED Talk. So let's do that. Let's create the reality of a life-changing TED Talk. The third step is you use a declaration, which is a statement of a new reality. And there are rules to the statement. It must be current and confident. This is a life-changing TED Talk. Notice there is no, I hope this is, or someday in the future this will be. This is a life-changing TED Talk right here, right now. Another thing you'll notice is we are declaring the reality that we want, not the reality that we don't want. If we declare the reality that we don't want won't happen, then it will happen. Many of us in our relationships are always declaring what we don't want. You never call. You like him or her. Don't you walk out this door. If you do this, you are creating the reality of your partner liking someone else, walking out that door, or never calling. To create the reality you truly desire, declare, I love when you call. I appreciate how much you like me. Please stay here and let's talk. While I was growing up, and I struggled with weight issues for many years of my life, and every day I would make the same declaration. I am not fat. Reality doesn't hear nots. The only reality I was creating were that of continued weight issues. And it wasn't until I made the declaration that I am healthy and that I only eat foods that are healthy and make me feel healthy did I create the reality of weight loss and all of the health that comes with it. Therefore, we focus on the reality we want. This is a life-changing TED Talk. The fourth step is something we've been doing for some time. It's called compounding. This is when we repeat our declaration over and over again until it becomes the true reality. This isn't an every morning and done thing. It's every time we think, we say, or we hear something that isn't aligned with the reality you're creating. For example, if at any time during this talk you get a negative thought, it's destroying the reality you want to create. Quickly redeclare that this is a life-changing TED Talk to keep the reality of a new life intact. The most powerful declaration that I ever made was when I was 25. I was super depressed. My favorite musician had just committed suicide. And I remember one day walking down the road, and I'm hunched over, and I'm protecting myself from the rain. And I am declaring to myself, I am not one who commits suicide. But reality doesn't hear knots. And it's clear that I'm up here, that I didn't do it. But I sunk deeper and deeper until I made a new declaration. I declare my life is magnificent joy. And I declared it, and I compounded it, and I declared it, and I compounded it. And about 7 months later, it happened. Since then, life has been magnificent joy. You may be wondering how you declaring that this is a life-changing TED Talk will actually make it life-changing. I mean, aren't I the one in charge of that? Isn't that my job to make it happen? The answer is no, it's yours. You make it happen. It becomes a life-changing TED Talk when at the end of this talk you go, that was life-changing. Hey Joe, you should watch this, it changed my life. And that's it. That's what creates it. When it comes to creating the reality of experience, there's a little switch in our minds. It's called a brain switch. Think of it like a light switch. You could flip it on or off. But in the case of your brain switch, it can flip from positive to negative, and from negative to positive. And in our example, we are calling our positive side life-changing. Once it's on, your brain will exclusively start to look for evidence that this talk is life-changing. And in any talk, this one, the one before me, the one after, anyone in the future, you could find at least one new piece of information that will change your mind. And because you flip the switch to on, you created the reality that this is inevitable. There's more. Earlier we spoke about how words inspire everything, how we feel, what we do, what we believe, what we experience, how we define life. When you make that declaration, we create the new reality that this is a life-changing TED Talk. You'll feel excited. You're about to have an improved life. What you'll do is you'll listen more closely. You'll take notes so that you remember the information that will change your life. Maybe you'll share it with your friends and family so that you could be even more powerful in creating the reality of your dreams, because remember, your reality is not just created by your words. It's created by all the words around you. And if you could help others around you create a better reality, then your reality will be better. In June, I declared that I am a public speaker. I had never spoken publicly before. I had no experience. I didn't even know what it entailed. But I declared that I am a public speaker. Later, that same exact month, I was at a conference speaking to this woman about nutrition. And she really liked what I was saying. And she said, "Harrison, are you a public speaker?" I said, "Yes, I am." And she put me on stage at that conference that I had no business being up there. And 8 months later, I've spoken in 6 countries, and I'm currently on stage giving a TEDx, all because I declared the reality of being a public speaker. It's not just me that has used my words to create new realities. Let's look at some examples in history. John F. Kennedy in 1962, the year after he was elected president, the reality was the USSR had already sent a man into space when the US hadn't even sent a satellite up there. 58% of the US public was against spending money on a space mission, and there was a belief among senators that it was too expensive. Then Kennedy got up on stage at Rice University, and he declared, "We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade." 1 year later, Kennedy was assassinated. 6 years after that, a man stepped on the moon in the same decade that Kennedy declared was going to happen. Kennedy took a reality in which there was no way the US was going to the moon, and through one declaration, repeated 3 times, and compounded over 7 years, he created the new reality that the US landed a person on the moon. And if you listen to his declaration, this wasn't a, "I hope we go to the moon," or, you know, "Maybe someday we'll go to the moon," or, "We won't be second going to the moon." No, this was, "Right here, right now, we choose to go to the moon," repeated and compounded until it became reality. In 1963, Martin Luther King gave his infamous "I Had a Dream" speech. This speech is widely credited as changing the fabric of humanity in the US. He starts off the speech by saying, 50 years ago, Abraham Lincoln signed a bill to free the slaves, but 100 years later, the Negro still is not free. MLK got clear on his current reality and the reality he wanted to change. He goes on to say, "This note was a promise that all men, black men as well as white men, would be guaranteed the unalienable rights of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. This is the reality he wanted to create. The current reality was the Negro is not free. The reality he wanted to create is that all people, black or white, are guaranteed the unalienable rights of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. There's one more thing for him to do, and that's to create it." And so he ends his speech with this: "Free at last, free at last. God Almighty, we are free at last. Not we will be free at last someday, or we hope to be free at last someday, or we will be enslaved no more. Free at last, free at last, free at last. Done, finished, present, and repeated until the reality was created." Lastly, Bill Gates, formerly the richest person in the world, was a master at this. In 1975, when Microsoft was a tiny company, Bill started declaring Microsoft is a computer on every desk in every house. And every time he declared that, he knew he was creating a future. He even thought to himself, "Oh God, can we double in size?" And then Microsoft went from a tiny company selling programming for computers the size of refrigerators into the reality of a $1 trillion company. The reality was computers were massive and very few people had them. The reality he wanted was Microsoft to be a big successful company. And his declaration was a computer on every desk, in every home, now. Repeated, focused, and compounded until it became reality. Any reality you want can be created with the use of your words. Be careful with your words. You are making declarations all of the time. Make sure they are consistent with the reality of your dreams. Be careful with the words you let into your space. Constantly ensure the words are consistent with your dream reality. Choose your dream reality over your favorite song or that new movie that will make the wrong declarations enter your reality. And lastly, consistently verbalize the reality you desire, and before you'll know it, you'll have created the reality of your dreams. Thank you so much. You've been a life-changing audience.